So now we are starting biomolecular mechanism for hydrolysis. Unimolecular mechanism for hydrolysis that we have seen already with the examples of NH3 and CCl4. Now we are starting with what that? Biomolecular mechanism for hydrolysis. Right? In unimolecular mechanism, what we have seen that these reactions which are following what that unimolecular mechanism, they proceed through formation of a cation. Right? Now here in biomolecular mechanism, the reaction it proceeds through formation of a transition state. Right? Characteristic of SN2 mechanism is what? So we say here the reaction or the reactions they proceed through what? Formation of a transition state. Transition state we have defined in our earlier lectures only, so that term we are aware of. So here in SN2 mechanism, reactions are proceeding through what? They are proceeding through transition state mechanism. Right? The very first example of SN2 reaction, this will be what that? Hydrolysis of SiCl4. Right? In SN2 hydrolysis, what we are considering? SiCl4 hydrolysis. Okay? In SiCl4, hydrolysis is very much easy in comparison to what that hydrolysis of CCl4. This is the first question of reasoning. Right? SiCl4, it undergoes hydrolysis very easily, while the hydrolysis of CCl4 was quite difficult. Right? So, why this is so? The reasons for easy hydrolysis of SiCl4. Right? So, the very first reason is what? So, here we say that silicon and chlorine, difference in electronegativity of these two atoms, that is what? It is more than that of carbon and chlorine. Right? In carbon chlorine, difference of electronegativity between the two atoms, that was lesser. While the difference of electronegativity between silicon and chlorine, that is more. And that this is because of this, what it happens? Silicon in SiCl4 will be having greater amount of positive charge over it in comparison to carbon. Right? Because of the greater electronegativity difference between silicon and chlorine, silicon here is having what? Greater amount of positive charge in comparison to carbon of CCl4. As it is more positively charged, so water in the form of nucleophile can attach here easily in comparison to what? In comparison to that CCl4. Okay? Now the second reason for this is what? Carbon was a second period element, while silicon in SiCl4, this is what? A third period element. Silicon in SiCl4, this is what? A third period element. While in CCl4, the central atom carbon was second period element. Right? So, because of this, silicon is what? It is larger in size in comparison to carbon. Right? In SiCl4, what we are saying that silicon is third period element. As it is third period element, its size is larger than that of carbon. Right? If it is larger than carbon, then what it happens? So we say, in spite of containing four larger chlorine atoms over it, it can offer water some space to partake. Right? Even though four chlorine atoms they are present over silicon, but still, water in the form of nucleophile can attack over it because it offers some space to water also. Is it okay? So in the transition state, silicon it offers what? It offers some space for attack of water, and hence what we say, its rate of hydrolysis is more than that of CCl4. Right? Third reason is what? As it belongs to the third period, it contains what? Vacant d orbitals in it. As silicon, it contains what? As it belongs to third period of the periodic table, it contains vacant d orbitals in it. Right? Because of the presence of vacant d orbitals, what it happens? Water in the form of nucleophile, which is taking over SiCl4, it can start sharing its electron pair in the vacant d orbital in transition state. Right? However, no such facility that was available in carbon. Is it okay? So because of these three reasons, what we say, silicon is more positive, silicon is larger in size, and hence it can accommodate water in the transition state. And third reason is what? So we say, as it is a third spherid member, this contains vacant d orbitals in it. Fine? So because of the presence of vacant d orbitals, water in the transition state can share its electron pair with silicon. Okay? Now in the transition state, what we see here, silicon is utilizing one of its vacant d orbitals to form bond with water. Fine? So here silicon is what it is, pentavalent. And hybridization state of silicon in this transition state is what that sp3d. Okay, so here what we say, this is important point for question, you have to note it down, that in during hydrolysis of SiCl4, hybridization of state of silicon in the transition state, so what we say, it is sp3d hybridized. Clear? Now when the transition state, it will be broken up, what we'll find that one of the fluorine atoms will be removed from silicon and in its place one OH from water that will be connected to silicon in the product. Fine. This once this oxygen is attaching itself to silicon, it is becoming more trivalent and hence that positive charge is being developed as oxygen. And as oxygen it becomes positively charged, what it releases from it? It releases H positive from it. Fine. So H positive is being lost from water and chlorine is being lost from silicon. So this H positive and this Cl negative, they will be forming what? HCl as the side product. And one of the OH from water will be connected to silicon. So the first step product of hydrolysis is what? It is SiOHCl3. Fine. Now one by one, all these chlorine atoms from silicon, they will be replaced by OH of water by the similar mechanism. Fine. Here what we are observing, three chlorine atoms, they are still connected to silicon. So silicon is still electron deficient. So water in the form of nucleophile, it repeatedly attacks over silicon till the time all the chlorine atoms are not removed from silicon. Fine. So one by one, these three chlorine atoms, they also will be removed. And final hydrolysis product of SiCl4 is what that? SiOH whole 4 and 4HCl. Got it? So this is what that biomolecular mechanism for hydrolysis of SiCl4. And here also we have compared this with what? Hydrolysis of CCl4. Is it okay? Now we are comparing what? The rate of hydrolysis of silicon halide. So in this rate, what we find, SiS4, it hydrolyzes to the maximum extent, and rate of hydrolysis of SiI4 is the least. Fine. SiS4 hydrolyzes at the maximum rate, while SiI4, it hydrolyzes at the minimum rate. Clear? This can be explained in terms of what? Lewis acid character of silicon in these different halides. Because of greatest electronegativity of fluorine, this silicon is what? This is most electron deficient. And hence water in the form of nucleophile can attack over this silicon at the fastest rate. Fine. So this rate of hydrolysis which is written over here can be explained in terms of what? So we say that is in terms of Lewis acid character of silicon halide. SiF4 is most electron deficient and hence is attacked by water at the fastest rate, while SiI4 is hydrolyzed at the least rate, and that is because of what? Its Lewis acid character is the least among silicon halides. Fine. Then second question is what? The rate of hydrolysis of SnCl4 is more than that of SnCl2. The rate of hydrolysis of SnCl4 is more than that of SnCl2. This again can be explained in terms of what? Lewis acid character of these two halides. In SnCl4, tin is in what? Plus 4 oxidation state. And hence it is more electron deficient. And as it is more electron deficient, water will be attacking over it in at much faster rate in comparison to SnCl2. Fine. In SnCl4, what we say, tin is in plus 4 oxidation state. Because of plus 4 oxidation state, its Lewis acid character is higher than that of SnCl2, where tin is in what? Plus 2 oxidation state. Fine. And hydrolysis is what? That is, beginning step of hydrolysis is nothing but Lewis acid based reaction. So here the Lewis acid character of SnCl4 is more than that of SnCl2, and hence water has greater tendency to take over SnCl4 than SnCl2. This also can be explained in terms of what that covalent character. Normally it happens that the halides or the compounds with greater covalent character hydrolyzes at greater rate. Right? Though this is not holding, that is not going to be true for all the cases. In most of the cases that is found to be true, but not in all. Right? Now the another example of hydrolysis is SiF4 hydrolysis. That is hydrolysis of SiF4. So here also exactly the same mechanism as SiCl4 will be followed. Right? Here also four water molecules one by one will be taking over silicon. One by one, what it will happen? All the chlorine atoms will be replaced by OH of water, and H from water will be going with this F. So here finally what 4HF in SiOH4 that will be formed. Fine? But what it happens here, SiF4 has much greater tendency to react with HF, which is what that side product in the reaction. Fine? So as soon as this HF is being formed, it starts reacting with this SiF4 to form this complex acid. This we call what that? Hydrofluorosilicic acid. Here, what we are saying that tendency of SiF4 to react with the side product HF is very high. So as soon as this HF is being formed in the reaction as the side product, it starts reacting with SiF4 to form this acid. This we call what that? Hydrofluorosilicic acid. Fine? When we combine these two reactions, what we get as the final product? So we say size of SiF4 plus 4H2O. These are giving what? SiOH4 plus size of H2SiF6. Fine? So here what we are observing that overall in the reaction, 3 moles of SiF4 are consumed. Fine? In the overall reaction, 3 moles of SiF4 are consumed. Fine? As not all the molecules are undergoing hydrolysis. 2 moles of it, they are being utilized in formation of this complex acid. Okay, so what is the final conclusion? So we say SiF4, it undergoes partial hydrolysis. Okay, as from 3 moles of SiF4, only 1 mole is being hydrolyzed. So the final conclusion is what? SiF4 undergoes partial hydrolysis. Is that clear? Now, next is what the example of BF3, hydrolysis of BF3. This also follows the similar pattern. One by one, all the fluorine atoms from boron will be replaced by OH of water. Here in BF3 boron, it contains what? Vacant p orbital. So water in the form of nucleophile, it takes over boron in the vacant p orbital of boron, whereby oxygen of water will be acquiring that positive charge. And then it will be releasing H positive from it. It is exactly the same mechanism as that of SiCl4. So when one by one, all the fluorine atoms, these are being replaced by OH of water. So the product obtained will be BOH plus size HF. Fine? So when BF3, it reacts with water. Initially it forms what? BOH and size of HF. Clear? Now here BF3 again has a much greater tendency to react with this side product HF. Clear? So the side product HF, it further reacts with BF3 to form what that complex acid again, HBF4. This we call what that tetrafluoroboric acid. Fine. So again this BF3, this was having a greater tendency to react with the side product HF to form this complex acid, HBF4. When we combine these two reactions, what we'll be getting as the final product? So it is 4BF3 plus 3H2O. What we are getting? BOH plus size of HBF4. Here again from 4 molecules of BF3, only 1 molecule is being hydrolyzed, while the rest of the 3 molecules, these are being utilized in complex formation. Here again in the reaction, what we are saying? So we are saying that out of 4 molecules of BF3 or 4 moles of BF3 which are being utilized in the reaction, only one of the BF3 mole or the molecule is undergoing hydrolysis, while the rest of the 3 moles, these are being utilized in complex formation. So here again conclusion is what? BF3, it undergoes partial hydrolysis like SiF4. Clear? So these two compounds SiF4 and BF3, they are undergoing partial hydrolysis. Well, SiCl4, that was undergoing what? Complete hydrolysis. Is it clear? Now we'll be taking further examples of SN2.